So the San Francisco 49ers are clearly making a conscious effort to try to improve their wide receiving core this offseason. One way they did that is with their second round pick, they decided to select Deebo Samuel, and I already made an entire video about him. But it doesn't end with him, they also decided to select Jalen Hurd with a 67th overall pick, and I actually think he could be a diamond in the rough. But one thing interesting about it is that he's not necessarily a wide receiver. He's actually, despite being 6'4", he started off his first three seasons as just a primary running back. He's kind of one of those guys where I'm not exactly sure how I would use him if I'm Kyle Shanahan, but he's just such a freak athlete, you kind of just have to take him. He's kind of just one of those guys where, you know, he's just such a wild card in any position. You could put him out there on the field and make people think you're going to have a four wide receiver set, but then bring him to the backfield and have him be a running back on that play. Or you could just be doing some jet sweeps and have him hand the ball off that way. And not just that, but he's also a pretty good wide receiver. So for a third round pick, it's definitely worth the risk in my opinion. He can just make some freakily athletic plays, and here's an example of him doing that. Where it's going to be a wide receiver screen, and that's where he is on a screen. He's on the top half. And so, you know, it starts off pretty simple. Quarterback quickly gets it over to him, and now he's actually just walks over to the first down because the defensive backs did not play as close as they probably should have on this play on a second down and one. So he basically just easily gets the first down. But now here's where something is interesting, because here's where a defensive back has an opportunity to make a tackle. And you might think, okay, 6'4", 227 pounds, he's a big guy, maybe try to run over someone perhaps, but that's not what he's going to do. Well, he is more than capable of doing that. He's going to actually try to use his footwork here. Notice how he's able to juke out that defensive back and pick up even more yards. So, I mean, that's pretty impressive. Being 6'4", but being able to move like that, I mean, that's not easy to do at all. He's a freak athlete, and he's just a talented player as a whole. I think that, again, I'm not exactly sure how the 49ers are going to use him in their system. I don't really know yet, but I have a feeling Kyle Shanahan has a pretty good idea. And let's be honest, Kyle Shanahan probably knows a lot better than I do. But one thing that I have noticed that actually I don't love is that sometimes he's not necessarily the best blocker. Which, okay, you know, not the end of the world, but it is something I would like to see him be better at, considering the fact that he is 6'4". Like on this play, it's going to actually be an RPO, where at first it's going to be looking like it's going to be a run to the left side of the screen, but in fact, the quarterback's going to keep it himself and go up to the top half of the screen. So that's where Hurd is on this play, and he's going to move over to the top half of the screen to try to make a block. That's what his job is to do. So right now, he is in an okay position to block, and as of right now, the quarterback looks upfield, realizes that he's not going to be able to make a throw on this play, so he is going to be running it up to the middle of the screen, meaning that Hurd's block is going to be important. What he's got to do is get his opposing defender basically as close to the bottom half of the screen as possible. He doesn't want that defender to move up to the top half of the screen. That's his job on this one. However, he doesn't do an aggressive enough job of moving up and trying to get into that way. And granted, it is a bit of a tough play because you can't start blocking right off the bat because that would be pass interference. You do have to wait until the quarterback starts running before you can then get up and make your block. But he didn't do a really great job of getting in position at all. He does push him over to the top half of the screen, but the quarterback kind of has to go down there because he doesn't want to get hurt. That one's actually a more forgivable mistake. This next one's going to be a lot worse, where it's going to be a run through the bottom half of the screen, and his job is pretty simple. Move out and block that Kansas State player. It's all you got to do. However, watch his block. He just completely whiffs on that block, and it's the whole reason why that wasn't a good run on that one. If he makes a good block, for all he knows, that could easily be a touchdown, but he completely missed it, and it led to no gain. Just not a great block from Hurd, and it is kind of surprising considering the fact that he is 6'4". You would think being that big, you could block better. His blocking is something that I would say he has to work on a bit. It's something I've noticed, and it is a problem in his game. But the chances are, you're not going to be getting many third round picks who have no flaws in their game, and if that's your biggest flaw, then I would say you're actually doing all right. One thing that makes him such an effective player is the fact that he is 6'4 and he has good footwork, and having those two things together can really make things a lot easier on a quarterback, and here's an example of how. That's his route. He's going to cut over to the middle of the screen, and take a look at how good of a stem he's going to run on this route. He's doing a great job at this point. I mean, if you just saw this right here and I didn't tell you beforehand he's going to be cutting in, you'd pretty much have no idea which direction he's going to cut. He could cut to the outside, he could keep going forward. There'd really be no telling, so that's a great portion of that route that you want to run. You want to not give anything away. It's kind of Julian Edelman-like in a lot of ways, because now the defensive back pretty much has no idea what's going to happen. You kind of have to make sure he gives Hurd space, because he doesn't want Hurd to just run by him, because that's absolutely something Hurd can do. So then when Hurd does cut in, he's easily able to get a ton of space, and again, because he's 6'4", it makes for a bigger target, and he already has space, making things so easy for a quarterback. That's the kind of advantage he brings in the passing game. You know, you already drafted Deebo Samuel, who's kind of a shorter speed guy, but now you got kind of the bigger guy who can make those tough catches, make those jump balls, and also still get open himself. And not to mention, you still have a guy like George Kittle, who, while is a tight end, can definitely still draw double teams and still make big catches on third down. So they kind of are trying to build a complete receiving core here. This next one will actually be kind of a similar example of what I'm talking about, but I think this one will actually be really key in showing that having the good footwork mixed with some good height can be really beneficial for in a wide receiver position. It's going to be a cover one hole, so it's man coverage, and that's going to be a herd's route. So, you know, it's going to be past the zone and coverage, but it's also man. So not only does he have to win his one-on-one matchup, but there's also going to be a tight window because there will be a linebacker in front of him that the quarterback will have to throw it over. Now, granted, Baylor does have a plan for that. They're actually going to be running play action on this play. So, you know, the hope is that the linebacker will move in to a degree, but that'll only do so much. So Hurd is going to have to try to create as much space as possible to try to make that window as big as possible for his quarterback to try to hit him. Of course, that's a wide receiver's job. Get as open as possible and play to odds that he will be able to fit it through that window. So one thing you'll see him do is once again do a very good job on that stem portion of the route and not giving anything away. And it's actually pretty interesting if you think about it, because what do you almost always do on play action? You at least have one route crossing over the middle of the screen, because if the linebackers do move in, then you can throw it over them. I mean, that's one of the main reasons why you will run play action, is to get the linebackers out of position by moving in and then being able to throw over them. That's kind of the whole point of play action most of the time. Of course, there's other reasons too, but you know, that is a key reason why. So you would think the defensive backs would have an idea that maybe that is where Hurd is going, but as you see here, Hurd is not giving anything away, and now his defensive back is not creeping over to the middle of the screen at all. And because of his height, this now means that the Baylor quarterback can throw even higher over to that middle linebacker than you typically would if the guy was maybe 5'10", for example. So now there's actually a decent amount of space, despite the fact that that's a tough play for him to make, and those are the kind of plays that Hurd can make, and he can make consistently. There's also one more thing that makes him very good at these types of routes, and it's his cutting ability. This guy cuts very well. He's an outstanding route runner, and here he'll do just that, where again, it's going to be a route where he's going to cross over to the middle of the screen, and look at how he's going to cut here. More specifically, look at how he's going to put his right foot down just like that, because up until this point, he was doing what he did in the last few plays as well, where he was doing a very good job of not giving anything away on the initial part of the route, and you can tell that by looking at this still image that the defensive back is still, he's just chilling there, you know, he has no idea which direction Hurd could go. Hurd could go to the bottom half of the screen, he could go to the top half of the screen. But with the way Hurd put his foot way out like that, this is now going to make cutting to the middle of the screen a lot easier. Because look at how seamlessly he will be able to cut to the top half of the screen. I mean, that's just too hard to stop if you're a defensive back, because you don't know what's coming, and just in a split second, he's able to cut over to the middle of the screen. So now he's open in terms of he's beating the man past him, but he's not open in the sense that there still is a linebacker in front of him. But also, because he cuts so quickly, this is now going to just give more time for the quarterback to try to make a throw, and basically gives him more time to be patient and let for Hurd to get past the linebacker, and then he makes his throw. Hurd makes the catch and able to pick up the first down. I think that'll probably be where Hurd shines the most, is those crossing routes over the middle of the screen on play action. I think that's kind of why they drafted him, but that doesn't mean that's the only reason why they drafted him. Probably the biggest reason, but not the only one. And one more thing that can make a 6'4 receiver be very impactful would be red zone situations. And this one will be an example of how he can be impactful in these types of situations, where it's going to be man coverage in the top half of the screen, and those will be the routes that Baylor's receivers will be running, and that's where Hurd is on the screen. He's the number two receiver. So, you know, he's going to be trying to go up to the top half of the screen, and this is actually a pretty decent route to run on a first down and goal. It might not be the play with the highest success rate, however, it's a pretty low-risk, high-reward play, where, you know, chances are this will not be an interception, because all that has to happen if it's thrown too high is it falls incomplete and it's out of bounds. Of course, you could throw it too low and it could be picked off, but, you know, basically you're going to tell the Baylor quarterback, hey, make sure you throw this one a foot higher than you're planning on actually trying to hit it through, so that way you won't end up underthrowing it. But anyways, take a look at Hurd's route. Once again, does a very good job of cutting. Once again, does a very good job of sticking that right foot pretty far out, so that way he can then cut up to the top half of the screen. That's nothing too fancy. That's something I've already shown you a couple times now. You're aware that that's something Hurd can do at this point. But one interesting thing is this ball is going to be a little bit of more of a floater than it actually probably should have been, and it's also is going to be a little bit high, but look at how Hurd is able to leap up and make that grab. That's just good body control and also good awareness of seeing where that ball is. I mean, that actually could have been an intercepted pass, even though it was a little bit high, because it was also pretty soft, so that defensive back could have gotten over and maybe been able to make a play. But Jalen Hurd was not going to let that happen. He was very aware there, realized what was going on, turned around, and was able to make the catch. Very good play, and I do think that he can be impactful impactful in those red zone situations for San Francisco, especially when you consider the fact that probably more often than not, you're going to be double teaming Kittle in those situations. So that means Hurd can be a guy you send to the outside and try to have make a play. I mean, basically, you could put Hurd on one side of the screen and then Kittle on the other. And if you're playing a team like the Cardinals, for example, where they put Patrick Peterson on George Kittle, well, now you have Hurd who can be able to make those one-on-one catches. So that's kind of what he brings in the passing game. But again, as I mentioned, he is not just a wide receiver. He is also a running back. I think that they're drafting him to play wide receiver. That's kind of what I expect to happen. But I kind of think he'll probably do both to a degree. I mean, if you have a guy that can do both, why not do both? And you're basically getting a free roster spot by having someone who can play two different positions. One way he can be effective in a rushing game will be something like this, where, you know, that's where he is. He is the halfback on this one. They have a fullback blocking for him, but he's a halfback. And what they're going to do is relatively simple. They're going to have the right tackle go out to block that player right over there, and they'll have the tight end block the player right in front of him. From there, their fullback will block the Kansas State player who's all the way on the bottom half of the screen. And then they're actually going to pull their left guard all the way over there who's going to go around and block the other Kansas State player. So really, the first Kansas State player who's going to be in the way here will be the linebacker who's second highest up. But at the same time, Hurd is going to have to wait for these blocks to develop. So once he does wait for them to develop, that linebacker is able to run over and kind of get into the way. This is a key play because this is a third down and one. And you know, a lot of lesser running backs probably would get tackled here if the opposing linebacker does make a good tackle, because this is actually pretty good leverage. But again, one of the things that having a 6'4 running back can do is allow you to kind of power through guys and even break some tackles. Not only does Hurd get the first down, but he runs over him and is able to get a ton more yards after the fact. I mean, that's just, again, that's an offensive coordinator's dream right there if you can do that. You know, you draw up a play designed to get 2 yards and it ends up getting 40. I mean, that's just what you love to see. One more play from his rushing game, and he was kind of more of a power back than anything. However, he definitely can do both. This one's going to be a run to the top half of the screen, and they also have a fullback who's going to be going up to the top half of the screen to lead block for him. For Hurd, you're basically just waiting until you see a hole. That's kind of what you want to do here. You're going to the top half of the screen and wait until you see a hole. So now that he sees a hole, once again, this kind of goes back to his receiving ability, where, you know, he cuts well, but also look at what he's doing here. It's very similar to what he would do in a receiving game, sticking 1 foot very far out so he can cut on a dime. There's not exactly a clear hole, but it's going to be enough of one. He's able to dive in for a touchdown. He's an interesting player. He is one of those players where I'm kind of like, I'm not exactly sure how I would use you, but I would want you on my team. He's a freak athlete with a unique talent, and when you have someone like that, you want them on your team, even if they're not necessarily built for one specific position. I think he absolutely could be a diamond in the rough, and I look forward to seeing if he will be next year.